Hello, my beautiful family. Welcome back to another worship with me together. Today, before we move into the exhortation, let us all listen to a song by Kenei Angami, and let us all listen with a prayerful heart and be blessed.
Life is easy when you're up on the mountain. You've got peace of mind like you've never known. But things change when you're down in the valley. But don't
Thank you so much, Kenei Angami, for a wonderful and meaningful song. May God bless you. And guys, if you are interested in listening to more of a worship song or cover song, then don't forget to check out her channel, YouTube channel, which I will put her link in the description down below. And yeah, don't forget subscribing to her channel. Today, let us begin with the exhortation on the topic overcoming jealousy and envy. So we all know what is jealousy and envy, and we always hear about it, but to be very precise and to be in brief, jealousy is something that comes out from the inner child that is within us. And everyone, every individual, no matter how old they are or no matter what gender they are, everyone has an inner child within themselves. And when we focus too much, or when we spend too much, or when we spend too much of our energy focusing on someone's life or someone's achievement or someone's happiness, our inner child, we feel neglected. And when we feel neglected, it starts convincing us by asking a question. I want what they have. And that's how jealousy starts creating within ourselves. And when we look into envy is something which is similar to jealousy, but of course it is quite different. Envy is something when you see at someone what you really want to have, for example, physical possession or maybe personal dreads, their talents or their job or something which you envy a lot, which you really want that is in someone's life. And sometimes envy can really lead you to a very positive impact, but you should be very careful, because when you envy someone, it should be very positive and you try hard to be someone like that person, and it might lead to achievement, but there are lots of drawbacks for that, because it may lead to jealousy. So let's look at where does this jealousy comes from, and how does it starts within us. So as I mentioned before, jealousy indicates the something that our inner child wants attention and love, or it's craving for something which is with someone's life or which is in someone's life. Jealousy also comes from an ego that reinforces a sense of self by seeing how less it is than the others. When you have this inferior complexity, when you feel inferior within yourself, you start to develop this some level of jealousy. We experience that, and I think it's very common for everyone. When you see someone is receiving a blessing, and that keeps reminding you how unworthy you are or how undeserving you are, and that inferiority may even lead to jealousy. And it always begins with a thought, that's not fair, or say, who do they think they are? Why don't I get the recognition? Or say, why is it only they who are blessed? What about me? Things like that can cause you, your soul or my soul. The question is jealousy something bad? No, there's nothing wrong being jealous or with being jealous, because it is a natural emotion that we show to others, or that comes from within our inner child, that which I've already mentioned. And this jealousy is not something bad, but the thing is, you should be very careful, because it can be very destructive and dangerous if you cannot take control over it. Now the question is, how dangerous is jealousy and envy? How dangerous is it? According to the psychological point of view, of course I'm not a psychologist, but if you look into the psychological point of view, there are various forms of jealousy, starting with emotional jealousy, destructive jealousy, or psychological jealousy. And this stems out from a low self-esteem and insecurities within ourselves. Some have said that jealousy can drive you mad, and it can lead to anxiety, depression, sleeplessness, and which is magnified in symptoms like post-traumatic stress disorder, and which is like over hypervigilance, irritability, obsessiveness. This kind of thoughts can develop within you. So that dangerous is jealousy, and it can also lead to a societal feeling. So but actually jealousy is a very dangerous for your life and my life if we cannot take control over it once it reaches a certain point of limit. If you look into the biblical perspective of jealousy, some of the examples we can take is from the very first book of the Bible, that is Genesis chapter verses 3-8, when Abel's sacrifice was recognized and respected by God, and Cain was jealous, and that's how he killed his own brother. And next is when we look into Numbers 16, we can see when Korah was envious of Moses, he was swallowed up by the earth. And the next is we can see how when Saul, the envy entered his heart against David, he lost his life in a battle. And lastly, Jesus was envied and he was killed because of the envy by his own religious leader of his time. And that's how we can see how jealousy have been so destructive. to oneself and to the people around him. But let us remember that James chapter 3 verse 16 says that, "For where envy and self-seeking exists, confusion and every evil things are there." But our question is, the most important is how to overcome this jealousy and envy. The first thing and the very most important is try to change your perspective of happiness. Because everyone wants to be happy in life, and we always live and try to live a life of happiness. And the only things that make us sad is when we cannot be happy. And that starts first when you are not happy with yourself. And you always keep thinking, "I think I'll be happy if I have a life like him or her. I think I'll be happy if I have a job like him or her. I think I'll be happy if I have a house, if I have a car like him or her." And that perspective of happiness that we have for someone, it's very important, because you need to change the perspective of happiness. Because your happiness will not be my happiness. It differs from each individual, and it comes in a different forms for each individual. So it is very important for you to identify what brings you happiness, or what is the source of happiness in your life. And you should try to define your own happiness rather than trying to look into things, your perspective of happiness or people's perspective of happiness, and try to think that I'll be more happy if I had this kind of life or like his or her life. The second most important is stop comparing yourself. Stop comparing yourself, because that's where jealousy starts creating within yourself. We used to compare with people, thinking like, "I think she's better than me," or sometimes we say, "I was brilliant and intelligent like her," or "she's doing much better than me," or "she have a better job than me," "I have a loved one around me like my friend." And those type of comparison, "I wish my family was like your family." And this type of comparison will only lead to destruction of your own life, and it will create more jealousy, because your inner self will want more. And your family, remember, if you compare yourself to others, you may become vain and bitter, because for always there will be a greater and a lesser person than yourself. Everywhere, no matter where you are, there will be always a greater and a lesser person than you. So stop comparing, and that leads to the third point, and that is be content and grateful with who you are and with what you got or what you have. It is very important to be content with what you got in your life. When we live according to the faith, it is very important to live in faith. And when we live in faith, we try to overcome the temptation of being jealous, or maybe say being envying someone. And day by day, we grow in contentment and grateful instead. When we are tempted, we need to ask God for the strength. We need to pray to God for more strength and focus on the cross that Christ died for each one of us. Everything in this earth is temporary. You don't need to compare. You don't need to wish for something. You don't need to wish for people's happiness, because everything that they got, everything you got, will be gone one day. It will be wiped off. This earth doesn't belong to you and me. Nothing belongs to us here. We are going to leave everything behind and go alone. So what's the point of wanting more than what you got? Everything on this earth is just temporary. It's not permanent at all. As Paul says, "For me to live is Christ, and to die is gain." My dear family, being jealous or envying about someone or something, it is just a wastage of time and energy and a waste of opportunities. And it steals away our joy. It steals away our happiness. Imagine, instead of investing time in being jealous or envying someone, what about being virtue instead? When we try to recognize our own boundaries and see instead how God worked on us differently, how God works wonders on us different from the other individual whom you are jealous of, you will realize how wonderful it is. We should not try to make more space than what actually God blessed us with, what we have received by God's grace. Let's all try to work hard, trying to overcome the temptation of being jealous or envy, and try to work in harmony and unity by being content with who you are and what you have. God bless you all. Let us all pray. Heavenly Father, we have been struggling to come to terms with the good things that are happening in others' life, especially the ungodly. We have found ourselves coveting what they have and feeling jealous countless of times looking at them. God, remove this ungodly feeling from our heart and replace it with godly jealousy. Help us to be jealous for your name to be glorified in every situation, especially in places where people have forgotten you. People are more focused in being jealous than in glorifying your name. Help us to be the channel of blessing, the torch bearer of your gospel. In Jesus' name we believe and pray. Amen.